Screens must be mounted securely in vibratory round separators. If a screen is worn or damaged, or you're replacing a screen with a different mesh, you can use this video which demonstrates how to properly replace the screen in your separator. To start, disconnect any flexible connectors from the frame spouts and cover inlet. If your separator uses a no-tool center tie-down, loosen and remove the center cap, noting the reverse threads, and remove the gasket. If your separator uses a standard center tie-down, loosen and remove the hex jam nuts. Then remove the washers. Detach the clamp ring by removing the coupling nut, washer, and bolt. If your machine has an over-center quick-release clamp ring, remove the clamp ring by pushing the catch to release the T-bolt. Unseat the clamp ring's channel gasket from the frames and set the clamp ring aside. Carefully lift the upper frame and remove it from the unit. If the screen assembly sticks to the upper frame when you try to remove it, do not lift the frame more than 2 inches, and gently tap the screen tension ring downward until the screen assembly drops back into its original position. Lift and remove the screen assembly from the separator. Place the new screen assembly on the frame, taking care not to come in contact with the center tie-down stud, which can cause damage to the screen. Make certain that the screen is right side up by checking the position of the tension ring. If the screen center disc does not sit levelly on the spacer or the bottom cushion washer, the pedestal or bottom hex jam nuts will need to be adjusted. On a standard center tie-down assembly, remove the screen. Remove the cushion and metal washers. Adjust the hex jam nuts up or down as required. Replace the metal and cushion washers and place the screen on the cushion washer. Repeat the process until the screen sits levelly on the washer. On a no-tool center tie-down assembly, remove the top jam nut. Then adjust the center tie-down pedestal up or down as required. Once level, lightly tighten the top jam nut to lock the pedestal to the stud. Now, replace the upper frame and reinstall the clamp ring around the frames. Clamp rings should be seated onto the frames with a rubber mallet before final torquing. All clamp rings must be properly fastened and tight before beginning operation to prevent them from working loose and causing damage to any machine parts. On a no-tool center tie-down, position the gasket over the top of the screen and replace the center tie-down cap by hand tightening to the top of the screen center disc. On a standard center tie-down, place the cushion washer and metal washer through the center tie-down stud and replace the hex jam nuts. Your machine is now ready once again for processing.